I'm Kaila Colbin. I'm the New Zealand ambassador for Singularity University here at Spark Lab in Wellington to talk about the exponential pace of change. One of the things that I think is particularly relevant to New Zealand is the way that these exponential technologies have the potential to impact agriculture. And I see those impacts coming from three different vectors. So the first is how traditional farming is becoming more automated. We see the advent of autonomous tractors. We see robots that can prune trees or pick fruit. So that's basically traditional farming doing what it's done, but using automation and technology to be able to be more efficient. The second vector that I'm particularly interested in is the advent of synthetic animal proteins, so bioengineered meat, bioengineered milk, bioengineered eggs. And these products are now becoming so good that they're really starting to compete with the natural products. Impossible Foods has a hamburger that bleeds and that sizzles and that tastes just like a burger, and it's made from plants. And so this is a product that you're saying it's not a burger that a vegan will eat, it's actually a burger that a meat eater will eat. And because of that, these products are becoming more and more mainstream, and their potential disruption to agriculture is much widespread. The third vector where I see this kind of disruption coming from is exponential increase in price performance of LED lighting and automation that makes indoor farming dramatically more competitive than it used to be in the past. So LED lighting, for example, has gone down in price by about 90% in the past 5 or 6 years. It's doubled in performance over that same time. And what that means is that it's now possible to grow indoor produce in a disused nightclub in New Jersey and supply New York supermarkets at price parity with organic produce coming out of California. We've got the world's largest indoor farm in Japan that is 100 times more productive per square foot than traditional farming. It generates 80% less food waste, uses 40% less energy, and most importantly for New Zealand, 99% less water. And I think all of these different directions mean that our agriculture industry is up for some potentially turbulent times in the years ahead. I'm Kaila here at Spark Lab in Wellington, part of the national tour of Spark Lab. Come along, get involved, get inspired. Thanks for watching.